I'm Bran, he's Chris. We put on a show you just can't miss. He says cowabunga, I say yo Joe. Welcome to the Chris and Bran Show.
Eventually Brent will get that editing program working and we will have music with it and dance people. We fired Barry, we hired somebody else now.
Chad.
First of all, this video intro and the stuff we're about to talk about before we get into obviously what the main event of this Chris and Brand show is, we are recording this after 123 Podcast. We recorded 123 Podcast last night. However, Skype was so wonderful to us. So we had to make a two-part video that has to be edited together. So we haven't had a chance to upload it yet.
Right.
So apologies in advance. We are going to be talking about something that happened that continues from there. So if you want to know where this conversation, I'll give my answer again too, just, you know, since it's before, but it happened towards the end of 123 Podcast. And as a matter of fact, the whole idea for this show happened during the end of 123 Podcast.
Right.
So it's kind of funny that this is going up first.
Yeah.
But I also want to apologize. My tweet might have been misleading. I said we were going to be doing watching Ash vs. Evil Dead at 11 o'clock. I wasn't sure if it was going to be a live show or not yet. I was going to post it at 11, but again, time, we kind of had to reschedule. So this will be going up hopefully around 12:01. So I know a lot of you guys are going to see this in the morning anyway. Normally, I would do this as a live show. But there are two reasons why I think it's better doing it this way. Number one, I wanted the quality for this video to be the best it could be. And let's face it, after watching Soma back, quality through the live shows, it doesn't happen. It's not as good as doing it like this through
right.
Skype. That's number one. Number two, I feel like any live show after 10, 10:30, well, let's say 10:30, close to 11, it's not worth being a live show because very few people you guys aren't really around after around 10:30, and that's understandable, you know. Or it's, you know, especially on a Thursday night, it's hard to be online for an 11:30 show.
Right.
So anything past 11:30, unless it's a midnight special, I feel would work better as a video anyway, because most of you guys see this then the next morning anyway. So it's not like you're watching it live. We are going to be watching Ash vs. Evil Dead Episode 1. It's free on Stars. So
yep.
If you'd like to watch along with us when we start, Brant will have a link in the description below. Click it. You don't even have to worry when they ask you for your age. Just click OK, because apparently Stars didn't realize it says January 1st, 1950, which is way beyond 18 plus. So you won't have any problem. You don't have to put your real birth date in. You're fine. I mean, if you'd like to change the month, go right ahead. I do it just for fun, but it's already at the right age. I don't even know why they bothered with it. I really am happy that Stars did this, though, because people like Brand, who don't have Stars, have a chance to at least check out the series, see if they like it,
yeah.
And maybe it'll show up on Hulu or something.
Yeah.
I'm not sure if it is.
I doubt it's on Hulu. Yeah, I think by law they have to put an age gate up. That's the only reason. So it's just like a formality kind of thing.
Okay, I got you.
I know it's like that with video games. You have to put an age gate up if it's a mature.
That's true. Yeah, that's right. So, all right. So, Brant, let's start with what we were talking about at 1, 2, 3.
First, we got sponsors, bro.
Oh, yeah.
You're right. First of all, we're brought to you by Kit Kat. I've only got one left because I've broke me off three pieces already. And, go ahead.
Fried chicken because
yes.
I didn't have dinner yet. And Pepsi, as always.
And Glacier Freeze Gatorade.
I love Glacier
Freeze Gatorade. Yeah, that's my favorite one.
That's one of my favorites also.
Nice. Simpatico.
Yeah, I think we did this once before, which is really hilarious.
I know.
So anyway, Brant, last night we were talking about, I was saying if I ever, you know, we were talking about our dreams and if we ever, you know, the things we want to do before we die. And one of them I mentioned, which was a pipe dream more than an actual goal, because this is something that if it happens, it's like, whoa, is
yeah.
to be able, you know, to pick a movie or something we'd want to star in. And I said I'd love to be a part of Ash or Army of Darkness 2, play as Ash's son or whatever. I even mentioned I would play a role as Ash's bastard son on the Ash vs. Evil Dead. And then I asked Brant, and Brant said, I don't know, I got to think about it. And I said, this is for the Chris and Brant show we're going to do tomorrow. So, Brant, you had 24 almost hours to think about it. So, where would you – what movie would you do?
All right. So, first of all, we kind of set some limitations, unspoken limitations. Like, it couldn't be anything mega like Star Wars or Lord of the Rings or anything like that, because that's just, like, way out of the reach.
Yeah, you so, got to sleep with the directors for that. Yeah.
So we had to scale it down a little bit. But I still wanted to, you know, go a little bit mainstream, something that I'm a big fan of. Well, maybe not necessarily the movies, but the franchise. So I thought about this long and hard, and it kind of ties into what I say in our little theme song there. And my pick is G.I. Joe.
You know, you would work in G.I. Joe. Yeah. I don't know. I mean, you could be the pirate, the captain guy. You could be who else could you play as? You could be the new if they get rid of that other idiot that's playing Dutch's part.
Duke, you mean?
Duke.
He died.
Duke.
Duke died.
Oh, he died in the last movie?
At the beginning of the last movie, yeah.
Good. So you could take over. You could be like Duke the Second, but they don't have to really.
I could be Falcon. I could be Falcon, his half brother. I'd be fine with that.
They just call you Duke.
Yeah, exactly. I'd star opposite The Rock. Come on, there you go. Even if it was like a bit part. I mean, it's G.I. Joe. That was like, I grew up on G.I. Joe. It was my favorite. So yeah, that would be my pick. I'd love to be in a G.I. Joe movie. That'd be awesome.
That would be awesome. I you know, G.I. Joe, maybe if they did like more of a classic, because I wasn't too keen. You know what I noticed, by the way, speaking of G.I. Joe in the comics?
Yeah.
They're doing Cobra World Order.
Yeah, I know. It's
Cobra World Order in abbreviation.
C-W-O.
And isn't that funny that we created Comic World Order about 3 years ago?
Yep.
And just now, this is coming out.
Mm-hmm. I'm telling you, it's a conspiracy, man.
Horrible conspiracy.
Does that mean we are Cobra?
Hell no.
That just blew my mind, man.
I will never be Cobra. That'll never
Cobra! But
if you want to be Cobra, I mean, yeah. Right ahead.
That first G.I. Joe movie was awful, I'll admit. It was terrible. The second one was a lot better, but it still left a lot to be desired. But if they did a third one, you guys are out there. If you're involved, call on me. I'm game. Yeah. I don't even care if it's bad. It's G.I. Joe.
Somebody, I'll play somebody.
I'll play an extra on the bench. I don't care. I'll say I'm in G.I. Joe, man. My life goal now.
You know, we were talking about this last night also now, and I cut myself short so we can talk about this a little bit. Next week, we got a lot of comic books coming out also, and that's – I've been really thinking about it since 1-2-3, and I believe me and Jay talked about this on GroupMe a bit.
Yeah.
It's really overwhelming, and Jay brought out a very good point, and we always worry about this. We've been – since I've known you at least, and since way back with Comic Related even – the fear of too many comics, too much reading, too much money.
Yeah.
It brings Mike Spiderslayer also said this. It jilts readers and consumers because it's too much. Yeah. Events like Secret Wars are delayed. It ruins events.
Mm-hmm.
So what were you saying?
No, I was just going to say, yeah, and it's you know, some people will say, like, okay, well, then just stop reading Marvel or DC and read the indies, and that's fine and well, but the problem comes in when you're a fan of Marvel or DC and you want to read those characters and you want to read those books, and then you're getting all this at the same time, and that's when it jilts you. It's because it's like, you know, I want to, but I can't, and it makes me upset, and then I don't want to support you as much because it's either you're giving me too much or you're not giving me the right thing, and I know we're fanboys, whatever you want to say, you want to call it, you know, we're going to complain. That's what fans do, right? But right. No, I think it goes beyond that, because I think it's really because we're passionate and we want to partake of the product, but when you put out that much, it's hard to take it all in. And granted, we don't have to read everything, but sometimes we want to.
That's the argument. You don't have to. But let's be honest here. There's three Avengers teams, the Ultimates, which count as the Avengers. There's Extraordinary X-Men. There's going to be X-Men. There's going to be A-Force, which is a female version of the Avengers. Uncanny Avengers. Uncanny X-Men. There's another X-Men book I'm probably forgetting. All New Wolverine. I mean, there's like books on top of books on top of books. And it's just – and this past week, I remember I had to make some severe cuts to my physical copies because it's too much. And the number one issue is at $5. Yeah. And next week is Web Warriors, $5. All New Wolverine, $5.
Yeah. All New, All Different Avengers,
$5. Yeah. That's $15 for three books right there.
Yeah, and you mentioned before, you know, you got Secret Wars delayed and all this stuff. And that makes it a problem, too, because you have Secret Wars series still wrapping up.
Mm-hmm.
3-4 weeks into All New, All Different. So, like, just this week alone, there are four Secret Wars. I mean, coming Wednesday, there's four Secret Wars books. There's three of the minis that are, I think, finally wrapping. And then there's Secret Wars number seven.
Yeah. Thor's is wrapping.
Yeah.
Infinity Gauntlet's wrapping.
Yeah.
What was the other one? I'm trying to remember the other one.
I'm looking.
Squadron Supreme, was it?
Infinity Gauntlet and Squadron Sinister, yeah.
Sinister. Yeah. All of them are concluding. But now I forgot. I'm like, yesterday, before I had to make my order for next week, because I always order the week before, I'm like, okay, we finished everything except, I even said it on the live show, I finished everything except Ultimate End, because they delayed it. And then the books come out, and I'm like, holy crap, I just realized this didn't end, that didn't end.
Yeah.
I'm trying to remember if there was anything else that didn't end now in my mind. And to my knowledge, nothing else. I think Age of Ultron versus Marvel Zombies didn't end yet either.
Okay. Yeah, see, it's too much. No, I think it did because the trade comes out next week for that.
Okay, then it did.
But, yeah, it's just, it's so much. They threw so much at you, and then it kept getting delayed and delayed. To now, we're already invested in these new books, the new status quo of 8 months later, and we're still reading all this Secret Wars stuff, and it's, I don't know, it was really mishandled, and it's made even more books than we would normally get.
I mean, my amount of money, now Marvel's the last place, well, second to last, because there's also the indies, but indies I already know it's a couple of Zenoscope, if there's Mega Man or Sonic, that, and then Valiant, if it's Ninjak or Exo. Everything else kind of is like, I'll browse through it, but really there's never anything outside the box that I really grab. Except Double Take, which I'll talk about Double Take when we're done talking about this, because this is a separate subject altogether that actually came to my attention today. But anyway, Marvel's my last big two company. I always start with DC. It's in alphabetical order, so duh, Marvel's going to be after DC.
Sure.
DC, in IDW, Image, I don't get any physical copies from Dynamite. I don't get any physical copies from Dark Horse. I only came out with – I'm trying to remember how much it was before getting to Marvel. And it was like not even $20 yet. And it was a nice amount of books. And it's the Looney Tunes variant. So it was still – it was a little bit above $25 at first before I did my cuts. Then we got to Marvel. And as you go down the list, it's like crap.
Yeah.
Crap.
Well, let me just read out. I'll read out all the books real quick. I'll do it real quick.
And I'll do a hand count as you're doing it.
Okay. All New, All Different Avengers, number one. All New Hawkeye, number one. All New Wolverine, number one. Captain America White, number four. Chewbacca, number three. Oh, I don't know if you're going to get that, so you might not want to count that.
I'm counting all the books.
Okay. Darth Vader, number 12. Figment 2, number three. Illuminati number one, Infinity Gauntlet number five.
Is Illuminati $5?
No, it's four.
Okay.
Secret Wars number seven, Spider Gwen.
Already.
Yeah, Spider Gwen number two, Spider-Man 29-9 number three.
Already.
Yeah, already. Squadron Sinister number four, Thor's number four, Ultimates number one, Uncanny Avengers number two, and Web Warriors number one.
17 books.
Yeah. And granted...
Go ahead.
You can take away Figment and Chewbacca because you probably don't get those. I guarantee you, most of the rest of those you would normally get if you could.
Physical copies, yes.
Yeah.
I had to make... I made severe cuts with them. Yeah. Severe with Marvel. But because of all the Marvel books, I also had to make some physical cuts from my DC.
Yeah.
Because it was just too much. It was way, way, way... too much.
Yeah. No, I agree with you. I was looking down that, and luckily there are a few of those that I wasn't even going to get. Like, I'm not getting Spider-Gwen or Web Warriors or Hawkeye. But still, I mean, that still takes me down to like 12-ish
books.
Yeah, 12-ish books from Marvel alone. That's a lot of money.
Especially, and don't forget Birthright. is coming out this
week. Yeah, Birthright comes out this week. I've got a few DC, you know.
Walking Dead.
Yeah, Walking Dead comes out this week. Back to the Future comes out this week. So, I mean, there's just a lot. It's a hefty week. And granted, you know, we know that there are heavier weeks and there are lighter weeks. Like, last week it was a lighter week. This week was kind of medium. And then next week's going to be heavy. And every month there's one real heavy week and sometimes two. But when most of your heavy is Marvel, there's almost 20 books from Marvel alone.
That's beyond heavy. Yeah. That's way beyond heavy.
That's a lot.
Yeah, and a lot of them, until January, I want to say, a lot of them are doubling up. When we went through the January solicits for Marvel, I believe Spider-Man was singled because they only had the point one, Amazing Spider-Man. They had Amazing Spider-Man and then the point one for the new point one series. Everything's back to singles, I think. One of the Avenger books was doubled. A couple of X books were probably doubled.
I think Deadpool's doubled. I mean, Daredevil. Daredevil's doubled.
And Darth Vader. Well, that's because it comes out in January. And Darth Vader is doubled all the way through.
Yeah. They do that. They've been doing that for years now. I mean, I'm not saying it's a good thing. I'm just saying we're used to it in a way. But it's still aggravating, especially when you look at when did all the number ones start coming out? It was last month, right?
Yeah, October, the beginning of October.
Beginning of October, we're already to issue number 3 on Iron Man, Spider-Man, and Spidey 2099.
That's two issues beyond one issue a month.
Yeah.
Already.
Already, and we're only 5 weeks in. That's crazy.
That means like every other week there was another Iron Man, another Amazing Spider-Man, and another...
Spidey 2099.
Yeah.
And it wouldn't be so bad if there were 2.99 books.
I agree. And the first books were $6.
Yeah. So.
It's way too much money, and I think that's why the consumers... Obviously, I can promise you Marvel's going to dominate the sales, but not because they're better than DC, not because they're better than other companies.
Because they put out more product,
Exactly. They put out more product, $5 each. Shoot, I wouldn't be surprised if Marvel's on top. It's honestly, I would disqualify Marvel because there's way too many books, number one. Number two, they're tripling and doubling the books up.
Yeah. And not only that, it's like I know both companies put out a lot of trades every month, and that's fine. But Marvel, when I used to do solicitations for comic related, I would notice that Marvel's collections section would be almost like it would be like half the size of its single issue section.
Yeah.
They would put out so many trades in a month. Just looking for this week, let's see, we got one. It might not be actually this month. This month's this week. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 or 8 trades this week on top of 17 single issues.
That's crazy. Even for DC, DC only puts out about 2 or 3 a week. A week.
Yeah, that's just 8 in a week. I mean, that's not even just for the month.
I agree. I mean, I'm not going to make other companies suffer because Marvel says, hey, we're throwing out all of our books, you know. So Marvel's going to suffer physical copy-wise from me, and that's their problem, not mine.
But it's reasons like that is why we decided to go through DCB service because, you know, we're at least saving some money.
Right.
And you get all kinds of discounts and everything. But, you know, and obviously if you have a file at a comic shop, you're getting a certain kind of discount typically. And I used to do that too. But, you know, you're not always guaranteed they're going to have your book when you get there either. As we found out, we don't have a file right now, but this week and last week actually there have been several books we couldn't find, and we went to 3 different places. So, I mean, it's
sell out. People want them really quickly.
Yeah. Or you know, different – they don't order, like, some of the smaller books because they're ordering all the mainstream books. And it's, you know
– That's where the indies suffer, and that's what sucks with the indies because indies have really great books. Like, I guess a good segue because I don't want to burn on – I don't want to burn this show on Marvel. Double Take – has been getting a lot of flack from a lot of sites I've noticed. And you said it best, I believe, because it was like, it's 10 books all in 1 week.
Yeah.
And honestly, they did skip a month, though. The first set of books, the number ones that I reviewed on Frontline, I'll be reviewing two books per video for five videos leading into next week, because next week the number twos come out, but they took a month off. And they do really good discounts for their books. You can go on their Kickstarter. I believe it was $15 for the full set of 10 books. Midtown only added another $2. It's $17 flat for all the books in a packet. Yeah. You can buy them. If you don't want all the books individually, they're only $2.50, so they're really cheap also.
They actually did have the 10-pack at Hastings.
Oh, they did?
Mm-hmm. And the single issues.
And I believe you had – one shop got prints. They actually got what do you call the 8x – not the 8x10, the prints like the size of the big ones we have for Last Ember.
Right.
And they were giving those away if you bought a book in a certain store. Now, I don't like that people trash – they're not trashing. I don't want to say that because it's not true. And I'm not going to point any fingers at any websites in specific either. But I read the 10 books. I went out of my way. You know, I saw them at New York Comic Con. I had seen the advertisements for Double Take before New York Comic Con. And I saw them at New York Comic Con. I got to interview one of the artists that does three of the books, which was Dedication, Remote, and Spring. Really nice guy. I got the first 10 books. I read them. Are they groundbreaking? Oh, my God. DC Marvel, look out, because Double Take's coming and they've got – whatever that guy's name is, Jimenez?
Yeah, Jamis.
No, I'm not saying that at all. This is a company that is, oh God, what's the word? Ambitious. They're very ambitious. They have this idea, and they took a product that's free to the public, because Night of the Living Dead, the 1970s version, is not copyrighted to anybody. So it's free for the public to do what they wish with it. So they took the universe and put their own unique spin on it. They made something different. Do you need all 10 books? Of course you don't. They are all in the same universe. They take place in the same area of Pennsylvania. I think that, and I'll say this in my reviews better. I don't want to give like direct reviews for any books. But I think that out of all the books, I only had one complaint about one book, and it was because the doctor, and I'm sure Brant's going to laugh at this, the doctor was talking about how he was a chubby, fat little boy who grew up, and he's talking about his life dating this girl who wanted to have sex at her parents' house, but he didn't want to get in trouble with the parents, and he was trying to convince – and this is all throughout an operation that he's performing. He's talking to this nurse. I don't know if he's trying to get with her. I don't know if he's trying to impress her by saying he was a good boy all of his life. But even the nurse, as the nurse says, you're a real charmer and walks off, I was like, this book was a real charmer, and I wanted to just turn the page and pretend that never happened.
Which one was it?
Less. It was Medic.
Okay. I was hoping you didn't say Dedication, because I know the writer of Dedication.
Dedication was good.
Was it?
I enjoyed – Remote was one of my favorites. Dedication was really good. Spring was a nice setup. I want to see issue two. I'll give you guys all the books I like, so it's not going to be a surprise when you see the reviews. Home had a hilarious little girl that Brant would hate because she curses like crazy, but I don't think anybody can hear her because nobody reacts to what she's saying. Spring was good, needs a second issue. Slab, I love Dr. Grimes in that book. It was a really interesting book because he knows what's going on, and he's telling people I'm going into reviews. Good book. Medic was another good book. If you just take out that one, 3 or 4 pages where this doctor's talking about his life, and I could give two craps about it. Soul was really good, along with I can't believe I can't remember all the names. I have the books right here, so hold
Demon.
On. Z-Men deserves the press and the move. I believe it's either getting a motion picture or it's getting a TV show.
Yeah. Home, Honor, 1, 2
of them. I got them. It's too late. I got them. Okay. Too late. Okay.
I was trying to help you.
Oh, thank you. I appreciate it. But I want to show the covers anyway. I think this would be better if I show covers also. So they know what.
Oh, while you're pulling the covers out. Real quick, the writer of Dedication is Matthew Yusumo. I think I lettered for him a while back. So he's an acquaintance. He actually lives in New York.
A lot of them, they all live in New York.
Oh, do they?
Double Take is based in Manhattan.
Oh, okay.
Okay, here's Remote. I can't see my screen, so I'm hoping you could make sure if I'm too close, too far.
You're fine, right there.
Remote was great. I really loved this issue. It was a fun read. It's about a woman who gets stuck in a radio station. I enjoyed it. Can't wait for number two. Here's Dedication. Really great story about – it's really more of a setup. This is like Spring where I need issue two, but it's really good because it shows this supermarket and they're locking up, and that's when all the bad stuff is starting to happen. I'll get into more of a review. This is Medic. This is the one with the doctor, which I wish I didn't hear anything about his life story. Honor. This book, I need another issue two also because I don't know where the book's going with its last page. Because there was an accident, and I think this is what leads into Medic. That's why I was saying there was an accident in Honor, and somebody dies. But the wife and husband, we don't see them, but the woman in this book and her husband just were in an accident. And in this book, they give the first names. In this book, they only say the last name. So I don't know. I know both women were in purple dresses, so I'm guessing what happens here leads into here. So this is one of those examples of how they're different books, but still connected somehow. I don't know where Honor's going, though, with the next issue. So I really need to see the next issue of Honor to see where who the main characters of the book are going to remain, like which characters will be the main characters. Spring, again, needs issue two, but it's a really great setup. Home has that cursing girl that Brant would just love to death. This is it. Rise and Soul both have characters from Night of the Living Dead. Soul has Ben, and they do a really great twist with Ben. Rise is about Barbara, and they do a really great twist with the zombies in this book. So both of these books were really excellent. These were one of my tops as well, along with Remote. Slab was another good one. This is the one with Dr. Grimes. And then Z-Men, and I can understand how Z-Men is getting a TV show. It's about these two agents. They're working literally in the the carpool. It's like this nothing, nowhere place, and they get called up. And they're, you know, when you get like they're these the lower tier agents, and they get put on this mission that if they do a good job with it, they're gonna be promoted finally, and they're gonna get out of the little crap hole that they're in.
Yeah.
And again, another great issue. I'll go into detail. My double issue reviews, I'll go into more detail. Like, I won't walk you through the book. But these books are available on Comixology, I believe, for free, the first issues.
Yeah.
If not, you can go on DoubleTakeUniverse.com, and you get almost the whole story. Obviously, the word bubbles and the captions are more on a more basic scale because I guess that was the Kickstarter images that they used before they changed up the lettering and everything.
Okay, I was wondering because On the ones I saw on the website, it was like all the text was at the bottom of the page or something.
Yeah, no,
like
they redid it with another letterer.
Okay.
And they actually went all out. It looks like an actual. I said the same thing to you when I saw it on the website.
Right.
They actually did fix everything. It's all word bubbles now.
Okay.
So it's innovative. I know it's different. And again, I'm not saying you need to go out and buy the 10 books. Not at all. My personal opinion is I like when there's a unique twist on things. When it's something that's a norm, I expect that from DC and Marvel. This book, you got these great writers and great artists. The stories range from average to above average, nothing below average in my opinion for these 10 books, for the number ones. They're taking a chance, and they're really trying to retell something and put their own unique twist on it, and I'm really enjoying it. It's something different. I like it because it's not all about zombies eating the flesh off of people. I mean, there is that, but there's more to it. There might be a twist with the zombies. Maybe – I say I don't want to – that's kind of getting into a review, but the zombies might not only want to eat humans. That might not be their goal, and shooting them in the head isn't something that – particularly may work. I'm not sure. I need to see a little bit more. Barbara's there. Her brother, there's something, there's a twist with her brother. There's Ben who, there's a twist with him. Like I said, he lives. There's a twist with that character and where that character is going to go now because he died in the original movie. So there's these little things, and Dr. Grimes is an awesome, like, doom and gloom character that's just, it's a really great series. And that little girl, man, she makes me laugh my butt off.
Yeah. You know, my only concern is them doing too much at one time, you know?
Yes.
Yeah.
That's the problem. And we were talking about this as, what do you call it? So we were talking about this before, that maybe it would have been easier if they would have separated the books.
Yeah.
What about you? Now, I don't know if you've read any of them before we get into the movie, because we are hitting we're going a little bit beyond here, and I want to get into the movie.
Yeah.
Really quick, I would love to hear your take on it as somebody who hasn't read them yet.
Yeah, I haven't read them yet. When I first heard about it, I was like, 10 books in 1 week? That's a bit much. And then we were talking about Marvel. So it's like, okay, maybe it's not that much. But, you know, starting out of the gate, I can understand some of the criticism they're getting, just because it's like the best example I can give is CrossGen. When they came out and they just like kind of flooded the market, and they did so much too fast that they ran out of money and, you know, closed down. Yeah. And it's, you know, Valiant was a very similar way. Valiant, the original Valiant, they did well at first, but they started putting out so many things and doing all these crossovers, and then they killed themselves, basically.
Gotcha.
And they went out of business. And it's just that it's history. And I think that's what people are kind of making fun of a little bit.
Yeah, that's too much at once.
Yeah, so I kind of worry for them that they're, you know, being a little bit overly ambitious. But at the same time, I have to commend that same ambition, that they are trying to do something different, and they're trying to they're giving opportunities to a lot of different writers and artists to get their work out there. I know the guy I mentioned, Matthew Sumo, who wrote Dedication, I know he's been trying to break in for a long time. He's done, you know, his self-published indie stuff before, but this is like his first real big break, I think. And you know, I as a creator, I have to really appreciate that. So, you know, I can't speak on the books themselves because, like you said, I haven't read them.
But on a company standpoint, especially because we work Last Ember Press, this is something that we definitely tip our hats to.
On a company standpoint, it might not have been the direction I personally would have gone in.
Right.
But you got to admire the fact that they had the wherewithal to – I mean, everybody knows about them because they've really been vocal. They're really out there. You've seen the ads on all the major comic websites. They're in the stores. They're in the Hastings. They're in the comic shops and everything. And, you know, marketing-wise, I think they've done a really good job. So,
have to see where the number 2, 3s, and 4s go. When we hit number 4, that's where I think even they'll know as a company where they're going to go.
Right.
All right. So we've spent enough time talking about talking. Now, Ash versus Evil Dead Episode 1. Brant isn't into this stuff, but I've seen it already, like I said. But I wanted to see, you know, we brought Kat on. We started Media Madness with Ghostbusters to see what she would think of a movie that we liked when we were kids.
Right.
This is something that I'm a huge fan of, Army of Darkness. It's no joke, no surprise. But this is not your type of style for series or TV. It's not a bad thing. It's just that it's not your cup of tea as far as all the genres.
Yeah.
So the first episode's free online. So we decided, hey, let's do a show about this. And we'll mark the time for you guys. So this way, if you want to skip to 30 minutes, you'll be at this point now.
Yeah.
But it's only 40 minutes long about. I believe it says 41. And that's including about a minute or two of credits. So it's about 40 minutes long. We decided to try it. So, guys, have your screens ready. We'll go do a countdown from 5. I say 0. You guys hit play. We skip the advertisement. We are at 1:04. So the music just starts to play. You pause, and then we'll start here. So are you ready for some interesting storytelling, Brant?
Let's go for it.
All right. I'm eager to see what your thoughts are. I'm not going to be surprised if it's not, like, amazing for you, but I would still – this is going to be interesting.
Okay.
And obviously we'll be giving our commentary as the series or as the episode's playing.
Yeah. I will preface this with saying I do actually like Bruce Campbell. I love him in Burn Notice. So
love Bruce Campbell, yeah. And Burn Notice was an excellent show.
Yeah.
All right. Ready?
Yep.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, play. I like the music they did for the intro. It's like, oh, this is the best. This we've seen in advertisements like a million times.
Yeah. So he's strapping on all this stuff. Okay. Since they can't see it, and I don't know, everybody's watching it or not.
Well, actually, it's more of a, not stuff, it's more to
it's suck a, it. It's a girdle.
One thing I was kind of disappointed with was they didn't go really from Army of Darkness's ending. They kind of went and set it up like it's Evil Dead's continuation. So Army of Darkness didn't happen. So no gauntlet. Like, he doesn't have that metal gauntlet that he can move like a hand. He literally just has a wooden hand.
Okay. He still uses the chainsaw, though, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Chainsaw was part of Evil Dead, yeah.
Yeah.
It's hilarious. I love the dancing and the high C.
Yeah. He's got an iguana or a dragon, one of the two.
Yeah.
Oh, he almost forgot the hand.
I didn't like. I would have liked to have seen the metal gauntlet from Army of Darkness. Remember this scene where he's like how he's dancing, he's happy, and just remember that.
Okay.
And look at the accidental use of the wooden hand here. Saw that? He bent his fingers to shut his door?
Yeah. They missed that in editing.
Yeah. whatever. I could ignore that.
He missed. It's funny.
I wish you... I don't know. I remember the way he looked in Army of Darkness and seeing this. It's kind of like... You could tell...
He's what? An 8-year-old boy.
And okay. Yeah, no, this is the... Okay.
Here
this is
go.
The scene you're going to laugh at.
Like, wow.
Completely clothed.
Yeah. Oh.
Yep.
He's gonna finish, really?
Watch this scene. Wait for the next scene. Wait, this is the scene. This is the scene.
Okay. He looks totally freaked out.
Same song.
Yeah.
I love it.
Uh-oh.
No, it's fine. But there's a problem. Uh-oh. Recap. Or actually not a recap, more of a flashback.
Yeah. Oh.
Oh, yeah.
Idiot. He's an idiot.
Yep.
Sure, let's just open the Necronomicon.
It's like, even high, I'd remember the piece of shit that I put through. I'm like, I lost one hand. You're going to lose the other hand one day. I don't like the girl. She sounds like she's drunk
more than
And we're back to the present. Boom! Title. That was an excellent intro.
That was an excellent intro. I'll give you that.
And now we get the... I don't know if you've ever seen Evil Dead, but this is something straight out of Evil Dead with the face flying through the forest kind of thing.
I've seen bits and pieces of a couple of them.
This is where... Remember I told you there were two parts? It was Ash's part, and then there was this agent's part?
Yeah.
This is the agent's part.
Now. Okay.
This is where things get a little freaky, though. Come on.
So is she the agent?
Yeah.
Okay. How's your chicken?
It's delicious.
Awesome. It's cooked.
See, I learned to desensitize myself so gross stuff could happen on the TV.
Yeah.
I could still continue to eat. Unless it's bugs. That's different. Then I can't.
You're making me want chicken. I'm like watching you eat instead of watching the show. I'm hungry. I haven't had dinner. It's fine. Uh-oh. Lights don't work.
Oh, I'm so surprised. Now, when lights don't work, that's your hint to get the hell out.
Yep. Somebody been having a party. Oh.
Yep. Somebody. Passed the party.
Uh-oh. What happened to Carson?
Not yet. Not yet. Not yet. Don't get ahead of yourself, Bram.
Okay. Okay.
Oh, it's freaky. It's a rocking chair rocking on its own.
So he's just standing there mesmerized? You think? No. Oh, I didn't hear it at first.
You're going to recognize that person in a minute. They slowly walk.
Nice and slow. Uh-oh.
Yep.
Ew.
That is freaky, right?
You could have just turned around, you know?
I know. They had to make it freaky.
Yeah, of course. Oh. Oh. Ah!
Yep. That hurts, don't it?
Mm-hmm.
It came out. Wait for it.
Oh. Buy cars.
That is why I won't have those in my house.
Yeah. Dang. Yeah, this is the part where you run.
That's some good effects.
Uh-oh.
But wait a minute. Wasn't he just dead? One of them movies.
Ooh.
I want to know how one of those little guns shoots that much power.
Yeah, I know. Don't believe him.
Oh, really? Was your friend?
Yeah, this is the part where you shoot.
I know, huh?
Man, that flashlight just spinning a long time, isn't it?
It done. Nope.
Ew. That is one powerful little gun.
I know, right? Final horn. No. They let the dog in.
Wow. Ah. Cookie wanted some chicken.
Mounted him, but, you know.
He looks like he's lost a little weight since Burn Notice.
Mm-hmm.
Froze.
Freezing. Pause.
Oh, there it goes.
Okay. I'm at 1558. Tell me when.
I'm at, well, hold on. It's still freezing. What the heck? It's frozen again. Hold on. Let me close some things. Oh, it's because I got a Skype message, I think. Close, close, close. Come on. Play. There we go. 15, 56, 57, 58. Oh, man, now it froze again.
Ah.
Crap. What the heck? There it goes. 1601. No. It's buffering or something. Okay, I'm going to pause it for a second.
Yeah, pause it. Let it load a little bit.
Yeah. When it starts back, I'm at 1610.
Oh, you're at 1610?
Yeah. Sorry about that.
No worries. So you're at the sheet.
Yeah. All right, I'm going to try it.
3, 2, 1, play.
So far, so good. Hey! Man.
Again?
Yeah. Might have to reload it. Yeah, it keeps doing it.
All right, reload it.
Let's see. I'll be at 1635 or so.
I'm at 36, so I'll wait for you.
Okay.
What do you think of it so far, though?
It's actually not as bad as I thought it'd be. I'm actually enjoying it.
Earth?
Yeah, I don't know what I expected, honestly, but I'm enjoying it.
Good.
All right. Let's see. Come on, let me skip.
Yeah, it will. Give it a second. Let it just play a little bit. This is the part of the show where Brand tries to get everything to work again.
Yeah. Stupid Skype.
I didn't Skype. You blame
no,
Skype.
No, it's on this other computer. So my Skype to me on the other computer. I'm watching this on. And I think that's when the problem started.
Oh, okay. It might have. That's why I have it on two separate computers.
Yeah, well, I do too. So.
I love how the internet lately, you have to have like almost everything closed in order to really watch it, something on the internet.
Yeah. All right, I am going to close the browser and restart it, I think.
Okay.
This is just frozen, though.
And because this isn't editable, there happened, you know, one thing Bruce Campbell did say about the Army of Darkness comics is they're not canon. He doesn't really support them because I guess Army of Darkness was kind of one of those things where you had an open contract there too. So anybody could take the name and try to run with it. So that or the studio had call, not Sam Raimi, like Evil Dead. So the studio gave it to Dynamite. And Bruce Campbell doesn't endorse it because he was saying that it's not canon. It's not stuff that they would have done with Evil Dead. And him and Sam Raimi kind of created that universe.
Yeah.
So that's kind of why he's not for the comics, per se.
Gotcha. Yeah, and you know, the funny thing is, I noticed going through the comics this week, Dynamite's not the only ones that do that. They do Army of Darkness, but there's another company that does Evil Dead.
Mm-hmm. Evil Dead 2 by Space Ghost? Goat? Space
yeah,
Ghost?
Space Goat.
That, we got the first issues of everything. We didn't get a chance to do it for Halloween Havoc, unfortunately, so. we aren't going to continue it, obviously, since Halloween Havoc didn't happen.
Yeah.
Coming along?
Still seeing. Seems to be. Let's see if it'll let me skip now. Okay, I'm at
1630.
16. Hold
I'm
on.
At
36. I'm at 43. So I'll pause. I'm at 45 now.
All right. 2, 3, 4, 5.
Okay.
And it's not S-Smart. He works at Value Stop now.
Ah.
I don't know. See, one thing I think that happened is I think he did work at S-Smart, but he moved. Because at the end of Army of Darkness, he was attacked.
Yeah.
So maybe he moved away to kind of get away so that he could hide away from the evil.
Yeah. Maybe. Mr. Roper. Good job, Ash.
That's the way he is.
I know.
As he still really? Steps on it.
And just shove him up under the pallet.
And there's his friend.
Raw. Monday Night Raw. Got some funny looking hair. Pablo.
Yeah. I love how his friend said, "I like this girl," and he's like, "Let me go talk to her anyway."
Yeah.
And
ouch.
Boom. And here comes your favorite actress. You could actually see her right now. She's in the white.
Oh, okay.
My question is, what does the evil want with this woman? What is her connection against it that it wants her dead?
The agent? Yeah, I don't know.
I'll die if she's Ash's daughter or something. That'd be messed up.
Man, it froze on me again. Oh, there it goes.
I'm at, what time, where are you at?
2141.
Okay, perfect. Same thing.
Okay. They think she killed the cop.
Yeah. Now watch this.
Oh. Yeah, she ain't passing the psych evaluation.
Now wait. That's her.
Yep. Lucy Lawless.
That's her only role in this entire episode, which pisses me off. That is it.
Huh.
I was hoping we get to see a little bit more.
Yeah.
We don't even see the agent anymore.
Oh, really?
Uh-oh. Normal people go for the exit sign.
Right.
This is Ash.
Yeah. Really doesn't like dolls, huh?
Guess not.
Okay.
Watch this. This is the best part.
Oh.
Ow.
Uh-oh. Yeah, I saw that one coming. Hi. Well, that doesn't look good.
Not at all. There's another part of that commercial.
Mm-hmm. Flashback.
Yep. That's when he was young.
Yeah.
I want a replica of that.
Of the Necronomicon?
Mm-hmm. That's Evil Dead 1 and 2.
Mm. It's gonna follow you.
No.
Oh, it doesn't?
He got away from it and hid from it.
Oh.
But again, he said it.
It hit me.
He has to finish what he started.
Mm. Uh-oh.
That car, that's Sam Raimi's. That's in every one of Sam Raimi's movies, even Spider-Man.
Oh, is it really? Is that? Wow.
This is kind of weird, this one. This is not a phone call. Yeah, and he's holding the phone.
Yeah.
And talking to her. Shut the door.
Oh, man. It froze on me again.
Really?
No, it's back.
Shut the door! Okay, where are you at?
No, it froze again.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the part of the show where Brant is going to get stars on TV. I'm at 29:27.
Yeah, that's where I'm at when it'll actually start back. Okay.
Okay.
No, not frozen.
I'm glad this is pre-recorded, so we can have so much fun after this recording.
Yeah.
So, for those of you who are paused here watching with us as Brant frantically types away to try to cancel out the problem that is stars, apparently, because stars. And I'm full. I had two chicken wings and I'm full already. Dang, I must not really be too hungry tonight. I'm excited for episode two, I will say that. It's a really interesting series. If you're a fan of Ash, and yes, I'm just pulling stuff out now at this point to talk about.
I was wondering.
You'll like the series. I thought it was a really nice introduction to the Evil Dead series for TV. It was already confirmed for a season two. Thank you, Tim, for letting me know. And thank you, Jay, for razzing me because I didn't watch Media Madness where you guys announced it. But I'm hoping that they make this a DVD set because I would love to see the extras that are going to come out of this first season. I think it's only 10 episodes. It's ending. You told me last night, Brent. It's ending around January, so the new year it's ending.
Right.
So unfortunately, unless season two starts like in summer.
Maybe.
That's what I was thinking.
It might be closer to fall, though. I'm not sure. All right. I'm going to try it again. I'm at 29:42.
All right. Well, I'm playing for a bit. She's here. She turns the phone. There's a woman at the door. Hand on mouth. And, of course, the phone dies. I am at 42 and 40. 1, 2.
Okay. So far, so good.
I hate this guy. And whoop. I love that, but no, you're not. It's back. We never get to see what that is.
Maybe we'll see it in the next episode.
At least you got it.
No.
Oh, and this is the part with the agent again that I forgot about. I'm at 31 flat.
I am now, but it's... What's wrong with it? Keeps freezing.
The Evil Dead doesn't want you to know.
I guess not. I'm at 31:08.
Okay. One, two.
It's still three, freezing though.
Four, five, six, seven, eight. I think it's the website. It takes a lot of bandwidth also.
Yeah, I'm going to lower the quality a little bit, see if I can get it to play properly. That didn't work. Ugh. This is aggravating.
Yeah, I know. It's kind of, I understand your aggravation. See, this is why the internet is a wonderful thing when you get stuff for free, but it's also aggravating when you can't get it to work.
Yeah. Alright. Refresh it again.
31. We only have 10 more minutes to go after this.
Yeah. Sorry about this, folks.
I was going to say our apologies. It's the internet. It's just the way the internet is. The world has internet problems. You're having internet problems right now, and you probably don't even know it. It's in there, knocking at your door, opening up your hard drive, tickling its little electrodes.
Okay, I'm at 31:10.
Okay. 8, 9, 10.
Okay. Ready? 3, 2, 1, play.
I'm at 15 now, so tell me when you're at 15.
Now.
I forgot the countdown. So, the normal thing would be not to go back to the house where you got attacked by evil.
Right. I don't think I'd ever go back.
I don't think I'd even be in the same state anymore.
Probably not. Not sure I'd be in the same hemisphere.
So I don't understand why she's questioning what she saw. Duh, it happened.
Yeah.
Oh, look, there's a piece of his shirt. Duh, it did happen.
That was kind of dumb.
This is the best part of the episode, in my opinion.
Okay. Really?
Of course that's fake. Bruce Campbell, I believe, has all of his teeth.
Yeah.
I doubt it's false. Yep. Although I was like, I guess we'll find out.
Yeah.
Well, let's see if you're going to die.
Why would you back up to the window?
Because it's a horror movie.
Oh, of course.
Watch. This is the first show. I love that, like, the light in the eyes.
Yeah.
And the same music when he got heroic in the movies.
Having a lot of visitors tonight.
Huh?
I said you're having a lot of visitors tonight.
Mike coming in and out of the room 3 times. And the dog is still in the room looking at the chicken. That
hey.
Doesn't happen.
It listened to her, though.
No.
No? Okay.
No. Blue shirt! Nah.
Ah, there it is.
Uh-huh. But
uh-oh. Ouch.
And there went the gun.
Ouch. Oh. Poor Pablito.
That had to hurt.
Dang.
Yes, fight, that's for sure.
No! Froze as soon as she punched a hole in the cabinet.
Oh, this is the best.
I know.
I hate you, stars, internet.
Okay, no. Come on, just hold out for me for 3 more minutes.
Everybody at home is like, I paused this video.
I'm so sorry. It's like going in and out now. Come on.
Yeah, almost there. I will say this. I promised everybody I was going to watch Army of Darkness, and we will be doing Army of Darkness as a live show, number one. Number two, it'll probably be... I want to do it sometime in November, because there is no way it will fit in a December month, because December is going to be fun, you know, nice. While Brant's fixing, I can talk one thing. I am doing an update. I did talk to Brant about a few things, because I had to confirm a few other things with the live shows that Brant and I do, with certain shows that are going to be coming up on this channel, with Last Ember Press stuff. And I'm going to do an Outside the Pages, because there is a humongous, not announcement, but an update in life, for one. Not something that's groundbreaking, not something that's going to change anything I'm doing now, just an update that's really cute, really nice. And then I will be doing an update video. It's going to have the blogger. Brant's going to help me work the blogger because I have no clue. I looked at that page, how to edit it, and I looked back at Brant and I said, I don't know what I'm doing. I gave you win. You could do it. I submit. I'm tapping out. So Brant's helped me do the blogger. That's why I'm waiting on the announcement until the blogger looks nice. There are some announcements I can't do yet, obviously, because A, I have to get them, and B, obviously, one of them, I want to wait for the new year. So there is another announcement that's coming in 2016, but it's coming right away in 2016. I'm talking like the first week, probably before Tommy's birthday, but there is another announcement that's kind of connected to Dark Avenger, but not. So there's a few things coming your guys' way very soon. I'm working on, you know, really, I know that right now the way YouTube has their channel layouts and everything, if you go to people's channels instead of checking your subscription feed, videos after number 4 are buried, and the reviews are something I really want to work on, not burying you guys, like burying shows like this where I really want you guys to see it, and then I've got like 5 or 6 videos, because Marvel decides they were going to release so many books. So I'm going to bury all the fun stuff I'm doing with reviews. I'm also going to be cutting back on reviews in the coming year. I will give you guys a little tidbit since we're fixing up the show right now.
I'm waiting on you now.
Okay, so that's the tidbit. We'll finish the rest here. I'm at 38.13.
I'm at 38.10, so let me play for 3 seconds.
Just tell me when you hit 13 and I'll hit play.
Now. Her nails growing?
Yeah. Good kick.
Yeah.
This is also from the commercial.
It's pretty agile for an old fella.
No, Bruce Campbell, I believe he keeps up with himself. He really does. Watch this. This is the awesome.
Oy. So much for a sweet little muffin.
Yep.
Groovy.
The best freaking way to end the first episode.
Yeah.
All right, I'm closing out. I'm not waiting.
Yeah.
I don't know. Maybe it's because a lot of people are watching it. Very popular stuff. But, man, I thought that was a perfect way to end the first episode. It was a great reintroduction to Ash and the Evil Dead. If you have no clue, if you never watched any of the movies, I think the recap was good enough. But what did you think of the movie now? Because we were freezing so much, I didn't really get to enjoy your reactions on certain things.
Yeah. No, I actually enjoyed it a lot more than I thought I would. It was fun. It was, you know, a little campy like it's supposed to be. But yeah, it wasn't quite as cheesy as I thought it was going to be.
I was expecting it to be a little more cheesy because of its origin, because of where it comes from.
Yeah, and that's one of the, I mean, I'm not a huge horror fan to begin with, and the cheese factor of those originals kind of turned me off a little bit. So this was a little bit updated, so I kind of liked it.
Well, they tried to do it like Ash literally aged however long it's been since the movie.
Right.
So I like that. It's better than just starting like right from point where they, you know, they left the cabin.
Yeah, exactly. So
I think that I would have liked it better if somehow they would have acclimated Army of Darkness. I guess the studios didn't give them rights, but I think it was an excellent first episode. I think this is a series. I mean, we were talking about this on Frontline Live also. This is a series where I can't see it going on forever.
Yeah.
Obviously, there definitely has to be, not finite, but there needs to be a cutoff. I think this season, this series has a, especially if it's only 10 to 16 episodes, if it's 16 episodes a season after this one, I would say it has about a good 6 to 8 seasons, maybe more. If it's 10 episodes a season, 10 seasons.
Wow, okay. I don't know if it would go that long.
It depends on the story and how far they go with the magic and if they travel, if it's about the book, you know what I mean?
I guess. I'd think more like 4 or 5, personally.
4 or 5?
Yeah. It just seems to be the life of, like, those kind of shows. But I could be wrong. Look at Supernatural. It's 10 seasons. So.
And still going.
Yeah. So, never know.
So if you had stars, would you consider watching the next episode?
Yeah, I'd probably watch the next one.
At first, I didn't know. I thought we didn't have stars. Then I found out we did have stars, so I could do it. Hooray!
Yeah.
And then my cable crapped out on Halloween.
Oh, no.
So I couldn't do a live show. But at least we got this video out. We got to watch it. You guys got to watch it with us. Obviously, it's not live, so we can't answer comments. So that's the only downside to doing these off live, but to be honest, at 12:57 in the morning, I would expect maybe one or two of you guys to be up, and I apologize to the one or two of you that would be up and would be really enjoying this. I am planning on doing a few more live shows. Now, what I was saying, I want to finish at least what I was saying. I'm working on doing more shows on this channel than reviews. I want to save the reviews for the blogger, but there's an announcement that goes along with that, so right now, that's why I'm saying it's going to impact this channel, because there's going to be certain things with Blogger that will allow for this channel to be more freed up for stuff like this that's out of the way, not like a straight-up review. Like, we discussed Marvel. We discussed the 10 books from Double Take. We watched a movie or a TV episode, and now it's just like recapping everything.
Yeah.
So I hope you guys really enjoyed this episode. Brent, is there anything you'd like, any closing remarks you'd like to give with this? Because I don't want to stretch this episode out too long.
Right.
So.
No, not really. I mean, if you guys are on the fence about the show, check it out. Hope you guys are enjoying these Chris and Brent shows. If you want to see more, let us know. And, you know, you can always check us out on everything else we do. LastEmperorPress.com, Zone4Podcast.com, ComicFrontline.com, and so on and so forth. Where's my tablet?
Reminder that Last Ember Press, there's still that contest going on, and the live show is this month. So if you haven't done the contest yet, go check out the last Chris and Brand show and do the contest, because we're going to be announcing a winner whenever the Last Ember Press show is.
Right. Yeah, and also we're doing that special sale for the print with the book and the buttons on LastEmperorPress.com. I think it's only running through Monday now at this point, if I'm not mistaken. But it's a limited time, so you guys need to take advantage of it. It's a really good deal. Fantastic print if you saw the last episode. So.
I wish I had ours to show off, but I really wanted to. I would have had it in the background or something for the content. That's okay. Whatever, things happen, but still. It's an awesome print. It's free. All you have to do is follow the steps in the contest, and we will announce you on Last Ember Press. See how many people are. Do we have a nice amount of people already in the contest?
Yeah, there's been several entries so far. Yeah.
That's awesome. So there's already several entries, but you can still win if you haven't done it yet.
Yeah.
Do it.
Cool.
So, guys, that's it for this Chris and Brent show. We hope you guys enjoyed. Brent, you got an outro song for us?
I do not have an outro song for us, because I don't remember it. Don't remember it. Come on, is that the song? Come on, you had fun with Chris and Brent. You listen to
this is Blue's Clues gone wrong.
You listen to Chris always rant about comics and the prices. Check out Double Ticket, Ash versus Evil Dead. And now we gonna go to bed. Bye.
I got it. All right, guys. Take care. Cheers. Have a good night. And we'll see you real soon. We do have another Chris and Brand show lined up. We actually have one for another TV show that's actually not out yet. It's starting soon.
Yes.
Here's your hint. And we actually do have to still cover Gods and Monsters, which I have to finish watching it. Brand finished it already. So I'm the one holding that up. Take care, everybody. And we'll see you guys real soon.
Bye, guys. I guess I should stop the recording, huh?
Yeah, I think it would be a good idea.
Bye, guys.